Ever wonder who you'd be if the Jedi hadn't taken you in?
Imagining alternate paths only takes one out of the moment. Jedi should always remain grounded in the present.
People say Jedi lack creativity. Can't imagine why. I should be dead or worse 1,000 times over. The first month after I escaped Korriban? Exciting. Not easy staying alive when you're a 10-year-old Sith fugitive. No friends, no food, no home.
Leaving Korriban sounds hard enough. How'd you manage that?
Helps if you're small. A head for Imperial transport schedules doesn't hurt. One day, a big freighter dropped off slaves and left with a stowaway. Jumped ship on Nar Shaddaa. Spent 8 years sleeping in alleys. Good times. Finally got caught stealing a starship hyperdrive. Should've seen Master Kowik's face.
Hyperdrives aren't much good without a starship.
Flying's hard. Taking stuff apart and selling it? Easy. Still remember when Master Kowik realized I was Force-sensitive and asked me to be her Padawan. It was... weird. Nobody ever gave me a choice before. Still getting used to that.
If the Empire conquers the galaxy, freedom will be the first casualty.
Along with Phazeball Mom and sweet flatcakes. I get it. Point is, I know what I'd be if I weren't a Jedi. And I'm never going back. You're not like most Jedi. That's a compliment. No offense to the Council, but if I stood around moralizing all day, I'd need a padded zero-G cell.
That's why you and I get along. We're not afraid of diving into trouble.
Trouble's only a problem if you can't handle it. Jedi need to get out more. Using the Force? It's fun. Mind and body supercharged. Everything's more intense.
I like intense experiences. How about a demonstration?
Whoa, tough guy. The Council would wag its finger at this conversation. Not that I care. Should probably get moving. Galaxy in peril and all that.
General, I'm on Tatooine. Has Master Kowik reported in?
Last we heard, Kowik secured our weapons research facility. She's missed every comm check since then. Enemy action is the most likely scenario, but on Tatooine, anything's possible.
If it's so dangerous, why pick it for your weapons facility?
Tatooine has millions of uninhabited kilometers, perfect for our research. Dr. Godera will brief you on the weapons project. Doctor?
The research facility on Tatooine has created a device codenamed the Shock Drum. The weapon discharges massive ultrasonic vibrations into the ground. It damages enemy fortifications at a microscopic level, quite literally softening them up. The vibrations will cripple people if they're close enough. But that's not all. The shock drum eventually disrupts the planetary core. At critical mass, the core explodes.
Imagine what that weapon could do to the Imperial homeworld.
My sentiments, exactly.
You're not in the business of destroying worlds. When the weapon's full potential became known, I halted testing. However, there's a fully operational shock drum prototype at our facility. If Darth Angrel has captured it, the results will be catastrophic. With no word from the facility or Master Kowik, you must assume the worst.
I sense Master Kowik through the Force, but it's faint. I think she's dying.
Can you feel her surroundings? Where is she?
Not sure. Somewhere dark. It's taking everything she has to stay alive.
I don't have any Republic contacts there to assist you. You're on your own. Our facility is located in a remote part of the desert. I'm transmitting the coordinates. Good luck. Mar Suthra, out.
Jedi! Seabrick, I told you help would come. We'd almost given up hope. Thank you for saving our little family.
You're not actually related.
Not all families are bound by genetics. Ours was formed by circumstance. Have you come to protect the shock drum, like Master Kawix?
What happened to her?
She defended us against Imperial soldiers led by a Sith. She fought bravely, but the Sith was stronger.
Kawix was a Jedi Master. This clearly wasn't your average Sith Lord.
I don't know about average, but I've never seen anything like him. I assumed he was going to kill us all. Instead, he captured Master Kawix alive and ignored us. The Sith destroyed your droids, but he didn't harm us. He said we were no threat, that we didn't deserve to die.
I've never known a Sith to show mercy.
It was almost like the idea of killing us insulted him. He wasn't kind, but I certainly wouldn't describe him as cruel. The Sith and his soldiers took Master Kawix and the shock drum prototype into the desert. Brick and I were attempting to restore power to this facility and track them down when the Sand People attacked.
Why would Sand People want a research base?
This facility can pick up the shock drum's locator beacon, but not until we restore power. The Sith knocked out all our generators during his attack. If you reactivate them, we can find him, Master Kawix, and the shock drum. Facility power's back online. I'm afraid that's the only good news I have. I just detected the shock drum's locator beacon. The weapon has been activated. If we don't shut it down, the device will soon reach critical mass. When it does, Tatooine's core will explode.
Why isn't the Sith deploying the shock drum someplace populated like Coruscant?
Tatooine may not be a core world, but there are still many innocent lives in danger. Pinpointing the shock drum's exact location from here is impossible. The seismic vibrations disrupt our sensors. The general region is thousands of square kilometers. We have to narrow it down somehow. Brick, that's brilliant! The ultrasonic scanners, of course!
Whatever you're talking about, we need to find the shock drum fast.
Ultrasonic scanners placed in a wide pattern will triangulate the shock drum's seismic disturbances. They'll reveal its location. Installing the scanners is extremely dangerous. The desert region is deadly. Ideally, we'd send an army. Your droids won't be ready soon enough, Brick. This Jedi is our only hope.
I feel Master Kawix reaching out to me. Something terrible is happening to her.
At least we know she's still alive.
She doesn't have long.
Take the ultrasonic scanners. Place them at these map coordinates. We'll contact you by holo once we've triangulated the shock drum's location. Good luck.
I sense your power. Now I understand why Tarnis was no match for you. His death was my failure. I should have trained him better.
The other Sith I fought were full of hatred and arrogance. And you, I sense regret.
My family is true Sith. My only passions are integrity and honor. I welcome the end of your kind. The Jedi obsession with my people's extermination must end. Your lust for revenge will destroy this galaxy.
You don't want this world to be destroyed. Help me save it.
I don't want this world to be destroyed. I will help you save it.
Now give me the code so I can deactivate the shock drum.
I will give you the code to deactivate the shock drum. I also have other things you may find helpful. Wait. Wait. What have you done? I approached you with honor, and you tricked me. How dare you?
Jedi save lives whenever they can. I was saving yours.
More lies! You won't confuse me again.
Come. Let us end this.
Die well, Jedi. Skill. So much power. Impressive. You could be a great Sith if you embraced the dark side.
Being a powerful Sith didn't help you much, did it?
You are simply stronger than me.
Darth Angrel commanded me to destroy the shock drum code. He wanted you to die in failure, no matter the outcome here.
I will not tarnish my honor with petty tricks. You've earned better. The code is yours.
You've done the right thing.
Darth Angrel ordered that Master Kuix suffer greatly before her death. I wish I had disobeyed that order as well.
She never did anything to him.
She detected Tarnus on Coruscant. Revenge is all my master understands. I left her incapacitated next to your weapon. If they haven't already, the ultrasonic vibrations will eventually tear her apart.
You scum! You should die like that!
There is nothing more to say. You won our duel. Finish me.
You may serve the Empire, but I won't kill you. You don't deserve it.
Then honor demands I surrender to my master. He will do what you cannot.
Jedi are taught to see all possibilities. I see one where you live on with honor. Commit yourself to the path of light. Become a Jedi.
Me? A Jedi? Impossible. Your order would never accept me.
Jedi believe in forgiveness, not hate.
Accepting a sworn enemy into one's ranks without fear, that is strength. I accept your offer. I'm too wounded to aid you, but I will surrender to your people. Now hurry, save this planet.
The Sith changed the deactivation code for the shock drum, but I have the new one. I'm on my way.
You're not there yet? Brick and his family are in terrible danger. They followed their droids to the mining complex. I tried to stop them, but they were determined to help you. Brick just sent an emergency holo. He says there's something called a sand demon at the mine. It's attacking them.
Some sort of creature?
That beastly predator is the only thing that hunts crate dragons. And those are massive. Brick doesn't stand a chance. Please, you can't let anything happen to Brick and his family. Save them and stop the shock drum. Hurry!
I can't sense Master Quix at all anymore.
I'll handle that beast, my friend. Keep your family safe.
Quiet, finally. I can breathe again. I've been down here so long.
Shh, Master, let us help you.
Kira and Orgus's Padawan, you're both changed. What has happened?
All that matters right now is you're safe.
I only survived this weapon by withdrawing into a deep trance. The Force itself became my armor. Sustaining the trance cost me greatly,
My strength is a fraction of what it was.
What you did was miraculous. We'll handle things from here.
I know you faced terrible dangers for me. I will not forget that.
Here you are. I was coming to help when sensors indicated the shock drum stopped. You did it. Rick wasn't exaggerating about the sand demon. I've never seen anything like it.
I almost hated having to destroy it.
My friends, the danger is not yet past. Even deactivated, that weapon remains a threat. You understand the situation best. What should we do?
The General can clean this up. We have other problems.
I will stay and guard it until Republic forces arrive. This cavern silence will be refreshing. I will see to the shock drum. You should return to your ship and inform General Varsuthra what's happened.
With the Sand Demon dead and Imperial's gone, you should be safe.
Before we go, you need to know something, and I'd rather you hear it from me. I never told you about my childhood. I'm not who you think I am.
So much about you is now clear to me, Kira, but you're wrong about one thing. You are exactly who I think, a strong, capable young woman. One day, you'll be a great Jedi.
If you could see what she's accomplished, you'd be proud.
We'll meet again on Tython. May the Force be with you.
Let's talk later. Feels like we ought to be saving the galaxy right now.
General, I'm on Alderaan. Have you heard from Master Orgus?
Negative. Considering the chaos there, it's a wonder any messages get through. Alderaan's a war zone. The nobles are fighting to decide who's in charge, and whether this world aligns with the Republic or the Empire.
I thought Alderaan was already a Republic world.
When we signed the Treaty of Coruscant, hardliners on Alderaan formally withdrew from the Republic. Unfortunately, some nobles took the opportunity to ally with the Empire. My people developed a Deathmark weapon to end this conflict with surgical precision.
Extraordinary device. It marks targets with a microscopic tag. Undetectable. Tracks targets anywhere on the planet. Feed the target's coordinates to a focused beam laser, and it can kill them from across a continent.
Since when is the Republic in the assassination business?
I can save a billion lives by killing one man. I'll gladly pull the trigger.
The Deathmark has one regrettable disadvantage. The targeting device's range is extremely limited, 20 meters or so. Once a target is marked, however, a laser can hit it from any range.
I fear efforts to guard the weapon have failed. Master Orgus's last transmission came from Organa Palace. After that, nothing.
Could someone in the palace have betrayed Master Orgus?
House Organa is the Republic's strongest ally. Something's happened, but not on their end. Count Alder was the last to see Master Orgus. He co-funds the Deathmark project with us. I tried informing the Count of your arrival, but communications there have been crippled.
Reports indicate multiple holo relays destroyed. Standard Imperial battle tactic.
House Organa can't spare the troops to get their holo relays online. Maybe you can help?
I'll restore communications and then meet Count Alder.
Transmitting holo relay coordinates. If you get them up and running, it'll tighten House Organa's defenses. You'll find Count Alder at the embassy near Organa Palace. Good luck. Varsuthra out.
Okay. Hey, what took you so long?
They said you were dead. Thank the Force you're alive.
The Force and my lightsaber. Needed both this time.
You've looked better, Master. Sure you're all right?
I've looked worse, Kira. I'll be fine. Blasted Sith almost killed me. It was all I could do to save Dr. Parvix.
The enemy left us here as food for the Killix.
Taking down that Killix leader must have been quite a fight. Thing was huge.
Master, I don't know what you're talking about.
The giant Killix leading these others. You didn't see it? That thing eats us. You're fired.
I'm fine. Just need to catch my breath.
You all right, Doctor?
Don't worry about me. The Death Mark is in enemy hands. You must warn Count Alda.
The Count was just killed by the Death Mark.
The targeting device was taken to Organa Palace.
Have you met a woman calling herself Elena Hark?
She was with me when Count Alda died. She sent me here.
Must have thought the Killix would get rid of you for her. Elena's a spy. She helped the Sith steal the Death Mark, and now she's targeting people with it.
She could have marked dozens of people by now. The weapon's laser can kill them at any time, anywhere.
Not if we cut its power. The laser's still tied into the local energy grid, right?
Several power stations supply the laser. Deactivating them would take the laser offline, at least temporarily.
Get the doctor to safety. I'll deactivate the power stations.
I have coordinates to every station. Deactivate them in the order I've described. Don't leave even one functional.
We'll head to the closest Republic-friendly camp. Meet us there. May the Force be with you.
Well, well. The Jedi who killed Tarnas back on Coruscant. I'd rather if you didn't shut down my laser's power stations. I need them. I have so many targets waiting to be vaporized. Who's next? The farm girl or the old colonel?
Point the laser at yourself and put us out of your misery.
Really? That's just rude. Oh dear. I'm afraid the farm girl didn't make it. I wonder how long the old colonel will survive. I can kill anyone I like, and there's nothing you can do about it. Have a lovely day.
Be reasonable, Duke. Your calls for peace are misguided, unnecessary. Lord Nefarid wants what's best for House Thule. Unconditional victory.
And all he asks is that I betray Organa.
What?
Who the skies are you?
I'm the Jedi who's here to rescue you from Elena.
You invaded my home. How many guards did you kill getting inside?
All of them. And now he's going to kill you.
Be warned. I am prepared to kill you. Lord Nefarid trained me to fight a Jedi.
What about two Jedi?
Guards, defend the Duke.
Kill me, at least tell me why.
The Jedi isn't here for you, fool. Not that it matters. No one will escape Lord Nefarid's purge. You're both dead, just like everyone scrabbling for peace. As the last person marked Jedi, you'll be the first to fall.
Why wasn't I a target after our first meeting with Count Alda?
I assumed the Killix would eat you. A mistake I've now corrected. If you're hoping to remove that mark on you, don't. I've just rendered the targeting device non-functional.
Then we've heard enough from you. Blasted woman has doomed us both. Unless we work together.
If you've got a plan to stop Lord Nefarid, let's hear it.
It's simple. Kill him before he kills us. I knew it would be wise to keep tabs on that Sith. Disgusting little men like him are always up to something. He's using a mountain bunker as a base. I'll give you the coordinates. Kill him if you can.
What defenses should I expect from this base?
The bunker repels torpedo bombers, and that's just the outside. Your work's cut out for you. I'm leaving for the spaceport. I'll try to outrun the death mark in case you fail, but first, this traitor dies.
If you want peace on Alderaan, you must realize, death isn't justice.
I'll put her in a detention cell until she can be tried and executed. Go, stop Nefarid, for both our sakes.
Master Orgus, the Death Mark device is destroyed, but I was scanned by it. Darth Angle's apprentice is targeting me. I'm on my way to his stronghold. Where are you?
Too far to help. I misled you back at the camp.
I haven't been searching for the apprentice. I've been hunting Darth Angle, and I just found his cruiser.
General Varsuthra's been hunting him for days without success.
The General doesn't have the Force as his ally. It called, and I followed. The cruiser's at the edge of the system, outside the reach of planetary sensors. It's about to jump for hyperspace. This may be our only shot at stopping him. I'm boarding that cruiser. Just wanted someone to know, in case.
You're a great Jedi, Master. If anyone can stop Angrel, it's you.
You're the finest student I've ever trained. Wish I'd met you sooner. Stop Angle's apprentice. Save Alderaan. May the Force be with you. Orgus out.
You truly are a stubborn one. Won't be satisfied until you've completely inconvenienced me, will you?
Come out from the shadows and face justice.
My master is transmitting the most amusing holo message right now. You really should watch it with me.
Assaulting my cruiser alone?
Very careless of you, Augustine.
It's not too late, Angro. Do the right thing for once. Surrender.
Pity you didn't bring your student. I could kill you both. Tell me, Jedi. Are you afraid to die?
There is no death. There is only the Force.
If there is no death, where is my son?
No!
And now I'll finish you. After all, you can't fight what you can't see.
I don't need to see you. I can smell you.
I'm starting to like you. What a shame you have to die. Oh, I almost forgot. The Deathmark laser is finally back online. And it's tracking you.
The Death Mark has been destroyed. Your people are safe.
I will inform Organa Paris immediately. We are forever in your debt. Duke Thule sent us the spy Elena as a show of good faith. She's to stand trial for her crimes. Her testimony will expose the Empire for what it is. No house will ally with them after this.
Darth Angrel captured and murdered my Jedi Master.
My sympathies. Master Orga seemed like a great man. Rest assured, I won't let your master's sacrifice be in vain. Be well, Jedi.
We should head back to the ship. Tell General Varsuthra about Master Orgus.
General, the Death Mark has been destroyed, and I have news about Master Orgus.
Darth Angrel broadcast Orgus's execution over the holodeck, left the body floating in space for us to find. A Republic shuttle has just recovered the remains from the edge of the Alderaan system. I'm sorry.
Orgus taught me everything I know about being a Jedi.
Darth Angrel has no idea what he's brought on himself.
Your master is dead, but he left us a gift. Somehow, he planted a tracking beacon on Angrel's cruiser without the Sith realizing it. Every time Angrel's ship drops out of hyperspace, we know where. Orgus got the last laugh.
It was a brilliant strategy, but I wonder if the cost was too great.
He paid it so others wouldn't have to.
Stand by. Report coming through. Angrel is on the move.
We just picked up the tracking signal in the Euphrates system. That Agra world supplies nearly half of Coruscant's food. I'm scrambling the fleet, but you're closer.
Maybe the Empire will send forces to help us take down Angrel.
The Empire's disavowed Darth Angrel. That doesn't mean they'll help us. Any damage to Euphrates food production could cripple the Republic.
One warship can only destroy so much.
Tell that to Terrace.
Transmitting Euphrates coordinates. Good hunting.
No sign of Darth Angrel, but Euphrates. I saw this planet once, with Master Kwix. It used to be green.
General, I've arrived at Euphrates. There's no sign of Angrel, but the planet. See for yourself.
Receiving your sensor readings. Stand by.
Euphrates' atmosphere looks like it's on fire. What could have done that?
Damage consistent with designs recovered on Ord Mantell. The Desolator weapon.
Angrel's taken the planet prison and turned it into something horrific.
Desolator borrows technology from all our advanced warfare projects. Angrel's son was quite the genius.
Euphrates had millions of citizens, whole continents of farmlands. All that life extinguished. The scale of this is... it's unthinkable.
Getting an emergency transmission. It's faint, coming from the far side of the planet.
Republic vessel, new copy. This is medical total game breaker. We're under attack. Imperial commandos have boarded us. Help!
It's one of ours. The crew may know what happened here.
No more of our people die today. Kira, plot an intercept course.
Already done, Master.
Strap yourselves in.
Thank you.
Was the last of the Imperials. You're safe now.
Not a minute too soon. Those commandos weren't taking prisoners.
I still can't believe what happened to Euphrates. When we arrived, an Imperial ship was attacking the planet. I've never seen anything like it.
Euphrates was trapped inside an energy field. Some starships tried to flee, but their engines failed before they could leave the atmosphere.
No one escaped. Every ship that tried crashed back onto the surface.
The enemy made sure there wouldn't be survivors.
We tried to run, but Imperial boarding pods overtook us.
I saw Euphrates' atmosphere catch fire. Horrific destruction. Flames consumed the planet. Everything turned to smoke and ash in seconds.
What happened to the Imperial warship?
It jumped to hyperspace. No telling where it is now.
Look at this. Our sensors detect faint life readings on the planet's surface. Possible survivors.
Anyone left on that planet is as good as dead.
If we go down there, we can provide food, water, shelter, medicine. It's our duty.
The energy field surrounding Euphrates will destroy your ship's engines. You won't be able to leave.
Can't abandon the survivors.
We're the only hope those people have. Every second counts. Please, he'll listen to you. Talk to him.
It's not that I don't want to help, but I have a family to think about. This ship carries combat-grade colto packs, battle adrenals, you name it. Talk her out of this crazy idea. You'll have your pick of our supplies.
I've pinpointed the strongest life signs. We can land immediately.
Render aid to anyone you find. I promise, you won't be abandoned down there.
This is insane. I'm taking an escape pod off this lunatic asylum.
My crew can do this without him. Thank you for doing what's right. I'm transmitting our sensor logs of the attack to your ship. Please give them to the Republic High Command. You better go. People on Euphrates need us.
I rescued the Daybreaker, General. I have sensor logs of Angrel's attack. However, the crew landed on Euphrates to help possible survivors. They're trapped.
We'll get them back somehow, but Angrel is our first priority.
Transmitting sensor logs now.
My initial analysis indicates the Desolator has a similar floor to the planet prison. The weapon's excessive power requirements demand a lengthy charging period before it can fire.
Small consolation. Angrel's next attack will undoubtedly be more direct.
The entire Republic should be warned about this.
Carson needs to begin food rationing immediately. I'll contact the Galactic Senate and put every Republic world on... Wait! We're getting another emergency alert from Typhon. Relaying it now.
Under attack by Darth Angrel. Launching defense fighters. Angrel's battlecruiser deploying energy weapon. Our ship can't escape Typhon's atmosphere. We're trapped.
That explains why Angrel left Euphrates so quickly. He's already chosen his next target.
Angrel's gonna incinerate Typhon, just like he did Euphrates.
He'll finish what he started years ago, the annihilation of the Jedi. The Republic fleet's in hyperspace. By the time it's redirected to Typhon, it'll be too late.
The Desolator needs time to work. The Jedi may be trapped on Typhon, but you're not. You could board Angrel's battlecruiser, disable the weapon before it fires.
There are other Jedi not on Typhon. Send them to help me.
I'll gather all the reinforcements I can find, but it'll take time.
I'll use the sensor logs to find the Desolator's weak point. Contact us when you're aboard Angrel's warship.
The Force be with you.
General, we got a little scorched, but we're inside Angrel's battlecruiser.
Yes, I knew you could do it. Now to end that Sith for good.
Won't be that simple. The sensor logs of Angrel's warship reveal he's amplified the vessel's reactors. That's a little trick he learned from me when I was interrogated by his spy on Taris. Blast his truth serums and mind probes. Disarming the Desolator weapon will necessitate overloading at least 3 shielded reactor relays. No simple task.
General, Doctor, my team's moving out. We'll save Typhon, or die trying.
Don't even think that. I expect us all to reach a ripe old age. Signal's breaking up. May the...
Angrel's jamming our transmissions. He's coming for us.
Thanks for the vote of confidence, T7. Be careful out there.
You will not steal my victory. Not now. I have sacrificed too much for this. I will avenge my son on you and all the Jedi.
Tarnas died because he refused to surrender. Don't make that same mistake.
Surrendering in my moment of triumph, that would be a mistake. I foresaw this confrontation. I welcome it. Today, I forge a new era for the Sith. One where the Jedi are finally extinct.
Finish this, Angrel. I command it.
With pleasure, my master.
What was that? I felt the Emperor.
You are his child. His eyes, his ears, his weapon to command. Come, child, fight by my side. It's where you belong.
I'd rather jump out an airlock naked.
Fight the Emperor's control. Remember who you are.
I feel him in my thoughts. We have to end this fast.
If you will not serve, you will die. For Tarnas.
Dead, and this battlecruiser's not far behind him.
Disappointing. Angrel was useful. This child must learn her place. And so will you.
Leave Kira alone. If you want to fight, face me in person.
That is unnecessary. I see futures in you. Futures I will not allow. Your future ends here.
Thank you.
This child is unfinished, weak. I will make her strong. Now you will die. Even if my child must die with you.
No, I won't kill for you.
You're resisting him. Keep it up.
The dark side has no power over me. I am a Jedi. He's gone. I won. I'm finally free.
Your life is your own, Kira.
And I have you to thank, Master. The ship's coming down on us. Let's get out of here.
Thank the Force you're alive. When I saw Angro's battlecruiser explode, I feared the worst.
We had some close calls, but Angro and his weapon are finished.
Saving Tython is becoming a habit of yours. Please come to the surface. Bring your Padawan to the council chambers. We all have much to discuss.
Welcome home. The Jedi owe you a debt of gratitude we can never repay.
The Jedi wore Republic medals. Your robe would be covered in them.
Only wish Master Orgus could share in this victory.
I'll honor his legacy to the end of my days.
We all will. He was a great teacher and a good friend. We've lost one of our noblest masters, but in his place stands a Jedi without equal. And you, Padawan. I knew you'd remain true to us.
I see no reason why we shouldn't make Kira a full-fledged Jedi Knight.
I agree. My troubled former Padawan has matured into a fine Jedi.
As leader of this council, it's my pleasure to promote Kira Carson to the rank of Jedi Knight.
You mean it?
It seems only fair. You did help save the galaxy.
So this is what it feels like, being respectable.
Danger to Tython is over, but we're getting fresh reports of hostilities all over the galaxy. Another war with the Empire seems inevitable.
Darth Angrel was the spark that lit the flame. Even in failure, he inspired the Sith to violence.
But he also forged our greatest weapon against the darkness. The Force has shown me what lies ahead. The futures of many rest on your actions. You will decide the fate of the Jedi, the Republic, the galaxy.
I'll defend the Republic to my dying breath.
May the Force be with you. With all of us.
Ever since our dance with Darth Angrel, I felt different. Good different. No more Emperor in my head. Sick creep was dragging me down, holding me back. Being free from that? Nifty.
You're positive the Emperor can't influence your mind?
All that's left are bad memories and an aversion to creepy old men, which is healthy. Sad thing is, there's plenty more people out there still under the Emperor's thumb.
I'll cut off that thumb. Then his head.
I'd start the other way around. Sith get nasty when they lose a thumb. We've still got a galaxy to save. Let's get back to it.